In this segment, we'll talk about the two arteries that branch from the internal carotid artery. We'll talk about the anterior cerebral, and then we'll talk about the middle cerebral arteries. The anterior cerebral artery is pictured here. You can, it's a, just a big, beautiful artery. And guess where it surrounds? Remember what lobe this is? It's your limbic lobe. So the anterior cerebral artery feeds most of the medial surface of the brain, and it covers areas in the frontal lobe, in the parietal lobe, and just a little bit of the area of your occipital lobe. We can see here on this diagram, here's that internal carotid. Here comes the anterior cerebral artery, and then there's that tiny little anterior communicating. So this is the area, this is what the anterior cerebral artery looks like. And here's a cartoon to indicate the area that it serves. Again, it's the medial surface of the brain, okay? And so it's going to feed areas of your frontal lobe, a little bit of your parietal lobe, a little bit of your occipital lobe. But what's really important is that those limbic structures, that limbic lobe that goes right around the surface of the corpus callosum. So any kind of a blockage that would cause a stroke in your anterior cerebral artery could have a very profound effect on the parts of your brain that make decisions and where your emotional tone is set. So your personality and those kinds of things could be affected by a stroke in the anterior cerebral artery. In the next section, this slide shows us the middle cerebral artery. And the middle cerebral artery, remember this area of the brain. Remember, your brain is so big, it's too big for your head. And so we have to fold it into sulci and gyri. Then we have to fold it again, and we've got cortex deep to the rest of the cortex. And this, as you recall, is your insula. Your insula then is fed by your middle cerebral artery, which is right here in all of its glory. That's a beautiful artery. We can see it coming from the internal carotid, and it's the one that goes lateral, kind of up here underneath. This is like the pole of your temporal lobe under here, and it goes up and around and comes out on the insula. The middle cerebral artery then feeds almost the entire lateral surface of your brain. And that's pictured here. So if we have our insula, and again, here's the middle, here's the internal carotid, here's the middle cerebral artery coming up behind the temporal lobe, the base of the brain comes up, insular branches kind of shadowed in here and then onto the surface. So it feeds the lateral surface of your brain. That includes frontal lobe, parietal lobe, and temporal lobe. So a lesion of the middle cerebral artery, a stroke or something blocking flow from that, would affect, again, your frontal lobe, and especially your precentral gyrus and your postcentral gyrus. And remember, your precentral gyrus is your primary motor cortex, and your postcentral gyrus is your primary somatosensory cortex. So blockages of the MCA that feed into these areas of the brain would have profound effects on your ability to feel any kind of sensation coming from the periphery. And it would also have a profound effect on whether or not you were paralyzed or not, because your upper motor neurons, your motor cortex, would be severely affected. In the next segment, we'll talk about the posterior cerebral arteries and the arteries to your cerebellum.